Good afternoon to everyone. Today I will talk about a procedure to estimate the devastating effect based on the imbalance computer-based test. Over the past few years, there has been a growing interest in the study of the impact of unmotivated test takers, test performance, and score validity, in particular in the context of large-scale assessment. Without sufficient effort, the problem is that it is difficult to understand the degree to which poor test performance is attributable to lack of knowledge, absence of motivation, or both. And the impact of disengaged test takers on score validity has been widely studied, and it is known that constitute a person-specific behavior that tend to negatively distort the achievement test scores, and this amount of distortion can be sizable, and it has been found that unmotivated test takers tend to underperform their motivated peers by more than one half standard deviation. So this is the reason why it's important to measure the engagement score in the large-scale assessment. Several methods have been proposed in literature to assess the test taker engagement. First, the test taker could be asked to complete a self-report instrument after the test event, but it is well known that this kind of instrument suffers of different potential bias. The students could overstate or underreport their effort, and another limitation is that the self-report scales typically does not provide only general information about the motivation of the student. The rise of the computer-based test have brought with it the capability to measure more aspects of a test than the simply answer selector or constructed by the student, and added to the development of additional measure of motivation. Thus far, in order to measure the student's engagement, the most studied variable that is collected by CBT is the item response time. The item response time is a quite complex variable because it's affected by several different factors, and the item response time corresponds to the time that the student spends responding to a single item. But what is of great interest, the first few seconds of the time that the student spent on the test. Indeed, there is a range of time that is far less ambiguous, because if a response occurs too rapidly, much faster than the time required by the students to read, understand, and select a response, one can reasonably infer that the test taker did not interact with the item in an engaged fashion. So using the item response is possible to classify each student's response as effortful or non-effortful. In order to identify the students and the response with rapid guessing behavior, the response that occur rapidly, the ideal distribution of the response time is bimodal, with one mode corresponding to the rapid guessing frequency spike occurring during the first few seconds, and another occurring later at the modal response time for the solution behavior response. In practice, the differentiation of rapid guessing behavior from solution behavior requires the identification of a time threshold, and several methods have been proposed in literature for choosing the time threshold, as for example the visual inspection of response time distribution, the common k-second threshold, and usually k range from 3-5 seconds. A new set of methods have been proposed and analyzed not only the response time distribution, but the response accuracy too. The accuracy is the probability to respond correctly at an item, and is estimated for each time point. And these methods are based on the idea that rabbit guessing behavior tend to be much less accurate than the solution behavior response. And so analyzing the accuracy across a series of successive time points, what we have to do is to identify the time point where the accuracy began to increase continually and from the accuracy expected from random responding. And finally, the normative threshold is an approximation of the threshold that is possible to find analyzing the response time and the response accuracy. And the normative threshold is equal to the 10% of the mean time. The aim of this work is to identify item response that are not a reliable indicator of the student achievement levels, to examine the amount of non-effortful behavior and study how effortful and non-effortful responses are related to student and item characteristics. Because this is the very first attempt to investigate students' behavior using the response time data from Imbalzi, in particular I work with eighth grade math items from the 2008 Imbalzi test, and I decided to structure the presentation in two different sections. First of all, I will give you an overview of how threshold identification methods proposed in the literature works on Imbalzi data. And in the second part, I will shortly show the results obtained by the proposed effort indicator. In this study, response time and response score of each closed-ended items of MAP test have been analyzed, and then a cleaning procedure has been applied to remove students with multiple access with additional time and students with outliers in the response time. The threshold identification methods used in this study are the common k-second threshold with k equal to 5 seconds, and the combining response time and the combination of the response time and the response accuracy that I call RI10 and RI20, and the normative threshold. In order to compare these methods, three different criteria have been used. Item response classified as non-effortful should be correct and rate much lower than those classified as solution behavior. Be correct and rate close with one expected from random responding, or at least lower. And should be informative because the non-effortful response does not provide information about the competence level of the student. And what we can see from this first table is that all thresholds lead to an average accuracy of non-effortful response lower than the accuracy of solution behavior, and moreover, the non-effortful response accuracy is quite close to the chance level that we can suppose range from 0.1 to 0.25 according to the number of the choices of the item. But looking at the accuracy of each item for the two different groups, the solution behavior in blue and in red the non-effortful response, the percentage of item with accuracy lower than the chance level, lower or close than the chance level, vary across the methods, and in particular the normative threshold and the fixed threshold methods show a quite high number of items with accuracy higher than 0.4. So what I observed is that these methods have two different limitations. First of all, the rapid guessing behavior the rapid guessing indicator became a weaker indicator of non-effort test for tests in which answer can be omitted. Indeed, the test administration software allows the students to answer items in any order they choose, to review and possible change the answer, and omit answering. So it is necessary to compute another indicator, the rapid omit indicator, that is able to identify the response where the students view the items but left the item quickly without answering. The second weak point of this method is that typically have been applied on timing distribution with a clear bimodal patterns. This is the ideal distribution of the response time for the identification of non-effortful response. But the observed response time distribution is not always bimodal and depends from several different factors. First of all, the item difficulty. In all these situations, the threshold works in a really different way and lead to the identification of different values. What I've tried to do is to classify the response time distribution according to different characteristics in order to study the shape of the response time distribution. And so I try to classify according the presence of more than one mode and the skewness indicator. So the proposed indicator of the effortful is composed by two different indicators, the rapid omit indicator, where the threshold is equal to 5 seconds for each item, and the rapid guessing indicator, where the threshold where the threshold depends on the skewness and the unimodality test. In this plot, we can see that the procedure proposed, the RTRI, they lead to an increase of the number of the item with an accuracy lower than the chance level. The highest value of the accuracy is equal to 0.3, but on the other hand, we can observe that there are several items with accuracy equal to 0. And it highlights that this method is quite conservative, and sometimes with this method I'm able to identify only the rapid omit behavior. Now I would like to show a few results, and we can see here that the mean accuracy of the two groups respect the validation criteria, and in this plot we can compare the mean accuracy and the mean response time of item aggregated respect the dimension of the item, arguing, knowing, and problem solving, and the item position during the test. First block identify the items that have been administered during the first 10 positions of the test, and the third block in the last 10 positions. And what we can see is that for the response in solution behavior, the accuracy is a decreasing function of the item position for arguing and knowing. And the response time too is a decreasing function of the item position. For the non-effortful response, we can see that there is not a pattern in the accuracy distribution, and this is a quite good result because we are supposing that the non-effortful response are not informative, and so we can see in particular for the item of the dimension of knowing, the accuracy is really constant and always equal to 0.2. Now, one of the advantages of this indicator is that it's possible to aggregate this classification into the different dimensions, the student level and the item level. At the student level, we are able to compute the response behavior effort score that is equal to the ratio between the number of the response classified as effortful and the number of the items. And at the item level, we have the response behavior fidelity, that is the number of the response classified as effortful and the number of the students. This is a great advantage because we are able to analyze the effort respect both the students and item characteristics. As we can see here, there is the distribution of the response behavior score. We can see from the table that the student with response behavior score lower than 0.9 is only around 3% of the whole students. The literature has been shown that the response behavior equal to 0.9 can be considered as a useful criterion for invalidating the score because the score is too distorted and could be not trustworthy. And I have only 2 minutes, so we skip this part. Okay, and for the response behavior fidelity, I will give you just a brief overview. Here there is the results of the mixed model where I studied the relationships between the response behavior fidelity, the position of the item difficulty, and the item dimension. And we can see that position and item difficulty are both significant, and the coefficient is negative. So, in conclusion, what I presented today is a preliminary study to understand the response time data. And I try to propose a new procedure to examine the test-taking behaviors. I think that this approach and this data give us several advantages because the response time is collected directly during the test event and give us information at student and item level. The effort level can be summarized at both item and student level. And this indicator gives us the possibility to check the student's behavior over the event. Here there are some future research that I would like to do. First of all, I would like to examine more in depth the problem of the threshold choice because I think that there is really a lot to do. And I would like to include in the analysis all the items. And I would like to include in the analysis other variables that describe the behavior of the student during the test. Moreover, the disengagement is well known that occurs most frequently with low-stakes tests and maybe could be of interest to estimate and apply this procedure for the grade 10. Thank you very much for that.